everybody, Wee Rabbit here, and welcome back to RLP of Disney's Epic Mickey Rebrushed. In the previous episode, we got through the Gremlin Village area, and yeah, it was interesting, right? It had all these people to save and stuff to do, and we got a bunch of tickets, so I think we're doing pretty good. And we made it to the European area, and that's what we're going to tackle this time with the, you know, Eiffel Tower, Leaning Tower of Pisa right here, some sort of Colosseum that looked a bit foreshadowy, right? So we'll see what's in there. But yeah, Legend of Dawn is here as I run around and try to convert some of these guys. Say hello to everybody.
I'm about to blow.
Oh, God.
No, what's up, guys? It's me. Legend Jonathan. Yeah, we are back once again for Epic Mickey Rebrushed. Oh, my God. This area has been so long. And again, it's crazy because you can really tell this is, again, like the beginning part.
Yeah.
And this is so long because this is even like, you would think we would have ran into like the hub already.
And, yeah, because I'm remembering the hub and like it's been like, what, like a long ass time since we even saw Oswald for like the last time. And,
yeah.
Like, it's really like crazy. Like, what is all this?
And the hub doesn't show up until like later. And it feels like, and again, this game is just long from what I remember. Yeah. Oh yeah, I remember that.
Wait, do we want to do it or not? Because he's warning us. It seems like he doesn't want us to do it. Or are we supposed to?
I think that ends up destroying stuff.
I was going to say, do I want to destroy stuff or not, though? Oh, you really actually don't want to?
I think no, in this case.
Yeah, because the fact that he's like warning us makes me think
that's
like,
why
oh.
Earlier he was talking about the thing that they were too, like the, you know, like if you sneezed.
Yeah.
That would imply that.
But you think it would be like a little hint of like, haha, go knock this stuff down. But then he's like, oh, careful, which makes you go,
no,
like, oh.
No, but earlier he was telling us to be careful, that's what I mean. That's why he was like, oh, like you want to be careful with those because, like, it seems like, yeah, they would fall over too easily and stuff.
That's what I'm saying, but I feel like that's not usually what games do. I feel like usually games encourage you that if they show you, like, oh, this can be destroyed, it kind of means to go destroy it, you know what I mean?
Oh, but you know how this game works already, that
yeah, that's what I'm saying.
Versus...
Yeah, that's what I'm saying, so that's why it feels weird. It's like, oh, I guess he doesn't want us to, like, do that then. Interesting. Alright, what's up there? There we go.
Oh, yeah, that reminds me, there is a neutral path in this game.
Oh, is there?
It just doesn't result in, like, I think it always just results in a good ending regardless, depending on, you know.
Oh, kind of funny.
But in this game, yeah, it's weird because...
How would you achieve neutral, though? Because good is usually you're
basically,
using
key. I think it's like basically neutral would mean that you do both things casually.
Oh, that kind of bounce it out?
Yeah.
Oh,
and
funny.
There's no way for it to... Basically, the game would have to generate a thing of being like, oh, well, since you lean more on the bad side, here's a neutral, like, kind of like a neutral bad, and then there's like a neutral good on the other hand, and then if you're like really good, then obviously you have like a really like the best ending technically, which is just a good ending.
Yeah.
And then if you're really bad, then you always end up with like, you know, it being bad. And the reason why I say this is because the game has different music for the areas depending on your stat, like what you've been doing.
Yeah.
So like right here, I think that because this is still the beginning of the game. And it's still kind of determining based off this too of what we're doing.
Yeah.
It does is the game as we progress, it'll have specific songs depending on what we've done.
Yeah, that's how I remember it being pretty interesting that it does like really. I mean, again, maybe it didn't do like the best job of it. Again, maybe because the technology or whatever. But it's really crazy how it was definitely trying to do some interesting stuff with the whole morality system and stuff.
Mm-hmm. Because yeah, I know like a level later where like if you keep on the neutral side,
yeah,
it'll just play the song from when we initially go to that place or initially have gone to that place. I'm not gonna mention which area.
Yeah.
But then if you play like the like you do, you're so evil basically.
Yeah.
Well, evil, you know, the thinner path. What happens is the music literally just sounds too depressing. Like there is no background instrumental or other instruments. It just sounds like gloomy like this.
That's crazy.
Like this, like literally just like the gloom part.
Yeah.
And so you literally like, you're just exploring a weird area that just has a really bad like music.
Yeah, it's supposed to have like a negative vibe to it basically. Mm-hmm. That's
and
crazy.
Then if it's like really good, half the instruments are gone, but it does have like the background instrumental for some reason.
That's interesting.
Yeah, and if it's like a good neutral or something like that, then it's just kind of like the original song that the person intended it when they created it.
Yeah.
And then the neutral is just kind of like the music, again, that we had already encountered from the start.
Yeah, all that's so interesting, man, how they really were trying to do something really crazy.
Mm-hmm.
With the technology now, maybe they could like pull off so much more. It would be really interesting to see what they could do, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
But sucks that I think this is all we're gonna get. I think this series is not really coming back, unfortunately, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
So that's pretty interesting.
Yeah, there's that. Unfortunately, and then you already knew about the Epic Donald already, huh?
Yeah, they were supposed to make an Epic Donald.
Because again, about that. One and two were so popular, and even Power of Illusion, which that's another game that we haven't mentioned because it's not really. It's weird to say it's
super different. Yeah, and it's super different too because it's just like a little platformer type thing.
Spinoff thing where like it's technically like it's weird because it's like. It's like a different. That's the thing. Like you could tell you really were trying to go somewhere, because it's like it's implied that that's like an alternative, like timeline or something like that.
Was it? I thought it was just supposed to be like more like a prequel. Like, oh, this is what he was doing.
That's why I don't.
Between like when he spills the ink and when he actually comes over here.
No, because he was already on Oswald's good side.
Oh, huh. Interesting.
And the thing is, it's kind of implied that it's after the first game.
Yeah.
But it doesn't. The second game never happens, or like the second game happens after it. That's what I'm saying. I don't really know.
You don't really remember, but it was supposed to be like maybe like an alternate path sort of thing.
Technically, yeah.
That's weird.
And then because again, since it's Power of Illusion, if you're a Disney video game fan, then you already know there's Castle of Illusion and World of Illusion.
Yeah, yeah.
And so it was just a part of that series as well.
Yeah. But yeah, again, the whole thing with the Epic Donald. Yeah, Donald was supposed to get his own game, which was kind of cool.
And then it was cool because you could tell like Mickey was supposed to be a playable character, but he was like the second player, which was really cool. And then like the designs were like more based off like the 50s to.
Oh god, dang! I thought he was gonna reach it.
Current. Oh shit. Current day designs. So like it's implied that some time happened where like this game would be like later, I guess you could say, from the other ones.
Yeah, yeah, exactly.
Which is really awesome.
So that's really cool. They had all these like different ideas and stuff, man. And again, it sucks that they just didn't happen, you know?
Yeah, it's all Anthony Mackie's fault.
Because he's like, I'm the Epic Mackie.
Yeah.
Not that dumb mouse. But little does he know that one day he would be working for that mouse.
Yeah.
Yeah. I don't even know what the hell we're talking about.
Yeah,
it's like so dumb. Like, what the hell are you talking about?
Oh, that was weird. Did you see how like the texture at the bottom kind of changed a bit?
Yeah, that was weird.
That was really weird.
That was pretty weird. All right, so let's get up in here. I think there's an opening over here.
Epic Butthole. Oh god, I just.
There
you
go.
Oh, there. I thought it was like literally a window. That was like, you know.
Yeah. Yeah, that reminds me. I wonder when the hell we're gonna get more freaking Kingdom Hearts. Kingdom Hearts 4 has just not.
Oh, that series is dead.
Oh god.
No, it's not. But what I mean is like.
And that's crazy too anything. Because I get why. I hate that if it's like a little bit tilted, you can't. I get why because it's probably because they want to get through like Misty Link first. Mm-hmm. But Misty Link also hasn't progressed at all, so it's like. You know what I mean?
It's a really weird.
And it really is weird because if you think about it, it's like the longest we haven't had any. New Kingdom Hearts stuff. Because there was always something happening Kingdom Hearts related.
Yeah, there was always some sort of announcement.
Or like, you know, remaster thing going on, stuff like that. And it just has not happened at all.
Or even a spin-off that was just made.
Yeah, there's been nothing. It's like crazy. I think it's like literally the longest we've gone without any new Kingdom Hearts. It's crazy. Yeah. Maybe someday.
I'm gonna be hitting my like almost 30s, and Kingdom Hearts 4 is barely gonna be coming out.
I know.
But yeah, Kingdom Hearts 3 Remind came out like when I was like exiting 8th grade. And
oh my god.
Here we are, like,
jeez.
I'm like, here we are. I'm not even in college anymore, I would say. And I'm like, I'm barely having Kingdom Hearts 4, so.
That's crazy. That's nuts, as Sora would say.
It is crazy though with the amount of time fans have had. Obviously, they keep analyzing the Mushu stuff.
Yeah.
And they're always seeing how it's crazy how, like, yeah, like, you can tell when Zigbar is acting the way. You know, like, when he shows more of his Mushu side.
Bro! Spoilers, man. What in the hell?
Oh, yeah.
I mean, not for me, but I'm just saying, all the people, they didn't think they were going to be spoiled on Kingdom Hearts from freaking watching Epic Mickey. Although, honestly, that's their fault. They should have expected this.
Yeah.
Because they're connected, you know?
No, guys. It's because... It's your fault for not playing the game 4 years ago.
That is true, too.
That is also your...
It's not their fault. That's like a mean way to put it. But you know what I mean. Where did that little, like, heart air balloon thing go?
It probably just went up and it, like...
It's gone, I guess?
Yeah.
Yeah, like, where'd it go? I was gonna, like, look for it and it's gone.
But yeah, there's a lot of things where people are analyzing and they're like, Jesus, like, you really look back. You could tell he really points out the stuff. And then, again, he already knew about you-know-who. And so, again, recurring even
there
though it was introduced in this
game. Oh, damn it.
Yeah, good. Just wait now.
Okay, but anyway,
the second game is that the whole thing about the look, you know, that he always points it out. That it's because, you know, he already knew the dude even before he met, you know, and the initial game he showed up in.
Yeah.
And so it's crazy to, like, bro, just, like, there's a lot of, like, stuff where it just shows that he was always just being him.
And no, you're giving too much credit to, Nomura. He makes this up as he goes along.
Oh, no one's talking about Nomura. They were talking about, like, the fans pointing out the stuff where it's kind of, like...
I don't know, but Nomura's the ones behind it, so... To say all this stuff was like, oh, it was there all along? That's giving too much credit to Nomura. Don't do that.
Oh, yeah, Weeb Rabbit doesn't like Nomura.
No, I'm just kidding.
Which, I mean, I will be honest, he's not really the best storyteller, legit, he really isn't, but...
You think so? I actually don't mind. I know a lot of people, like, shit on, like, people, like,
Nomura, no, I'm not saying or, he's like, bad. Like, I'm saying that, like, to say he's
But I guess what I mean is, like, what's the problem, though?
There isn't. I'm just saying that it's not the best, you know what I mean? Like,
that's what I'm saying, but if you say there's the best, it's because you're probably, like, some issues. What are the issues, I'm saying, that you have?
That, yeah, there is a lot of retcons, that's for sure, you know? And then,
What else am I looking for? What am I supposed to do now?
Climb those, I guess.
I guess, right? Because I'm not really seeing anything else.
That's pretty much it. And what else? Yeah, retcons. There are times where they always try to, like,
Like what?
That's what I'm thinking.
Oh, okay. No, I was already on these. There's nothing else up here. Huh, what's next, actually?
That's weird. But yeah, then there's the thing where, like, they'll, like, literally be like, oh yeah, like...
Yeah, how am I supposed to get across? What the heck?
Oh, the time travel thing was kind of weird. Especially when they first introduced it, it was kind
of
weird.
No! Oh, god dang it. Yeah, like, once you're... That's what I hate. Once you fall on a thing, why is it... You might as well just automatically kill you, because there's no way you're going to get back up. You know what I mean? Like,
or it's because it tries to give you a chance when it's, like, a smaller platform, I guess.
Yeah, I guess. Yeah, put us back up here. Yeah, what am I missing? I feel like... Yeah, I know I need to get over there somehow, but I feel like I can't get over there. Because I need to get over... Oh, maybe the boats. I guess I have to jump on them backwards. I guess that's what it must be, because look.
Yeah, jump on it. Oh, shit. Oh my God. The good thing is you caught the ride, so.
Wait, but how would I reach the next one? I don't think I can do what I was thinking. So I was thinking, like, oh, I'll just jump backwards
on
them?
I don't think there's too much backwards.
Maybe over here? Hold on.
Just like that, yeah.
Because he can't reach that, right? At least last time he did. Let me see if I can... Okay, this time he reached it. There we go. I guess since I died, I never thought of going back over here. Yeah. That's probably what it was then. Okay. So that's what it was. Okay. Okay, so we're in the right direction now, I think. Okay. Oh, but yeah, the Wreck-It Ralph game is just, like, really shit then, you said?
Yeah, and I'm telling you, everyone's like, Jesus Christ, they spent all the budget on the freaking
cutscene
opening. That's it.
That is crazy. What's the gameplay for that anyway? Is it like a platformer?
It's a really shitty platformer.
Really?
And, like, I think both Ralph and what's-his-name have different gameplay where, like, one can be kind of like the equivalent of King Dedede or Bowser where they punch a lot and a bunch of other stuff.
Yeah.
While the other guy's more like Mario.
That's funny.
But it's still not great. Like, regardless of how to describe it, it's still not great because I think, like, again, it's crazy because I never noticed it as a kid, but again, I also grew up with the Wii, so, like, when you, like, look at, like, when you're growing up in a generation where those are, like, the best graphics, quote-unquote.
Yeah.
There's no way because 480 is the only thing you have, you know what I mean? Like,
yeah.
But regardless, I've seen it, and it's just so bad, and, like,
that's
a lot
crazy.
Of people were even mentioning it, that they had it, and they're like, Jesus, like, when you're, like, a kid and you play a game, like, it's crazy not noticing how good a game, like, or how bad a game was, you know what I mean?
Yeah, yeah. That's crazy. That was that. The fact that it's, like, that bad is crazy.
And, like, Ralph looks really, like, I don't even know what.
Like a crackhead.
He kind of does, where he looks like a weird, like, Bigfoot motherfucker. No way.
Bigfoot motherfucker.
And then, like, what's his name? Fix-It Felix just looks like him, but, like, really low poly and, like...
Oh, my God. Dude. Jump.
He looks lame as hell, and...
That is funny, man.
It's depressing, like...
You're like, it's depressing?
It kind of is, like...
Like, it made me sad.
Like, obviously, it wasn't gonna be great, because that was, like, the... That's the thing, the early 2010s was, like... No, early to mid-2010s, I'm sorry about that.
Yeah.
Is where they started to finish that whole movie video games thing.
Because, oh, like, licensed games, you mean?
Yeah, because I know, like, I forgot what it was, it's someone... it was funny, I checked the PlayStation, like, their account.
Oh my god, damn it. He doesn't freaking... He can't reach that. Oh my god. So he can't reach that part, right?
I checked their activity, and I guess they played a video game movie game?
Yeah.
And I forgot what they played, but it seemed like that was more recent. But you can tell it's just not common.
Yeah.
Yeah. Like, it's not a common genre. And then, honestly, it's kind of good that it isn't.
Oh my gosh.
Because, like, the Polar Express game.
Oh god.
Like, you know what I'm talking
about.
Yeah,
a lot of those, I'm saying, a lot of those licensed games are just so bad. Because they're literally just meant to be, to, like, just, like, promote, you know, certain stuff.
Yeah.
And then they're, like, not good, which is funny.
Yeah, like, I know, what's it called? Freaking,
How are you supposed to do that? Like, what the hell?
It's like a... I guess you're supposed to stop each and every...
Yeah, hold on.
Yeah, it's supposed to be like a perfect... There you go.
Hopefully that'll work. We'll have to see right now. Because it might be too tilted, yeah. You know what I mean? But we'll see.
And yeah, and you mentioned like the Credibles game that you've played.
Oh yeah, the Credibles game was like super whack, man.
Yeah, there's the whole thing where like...
It's like they really like just wanted to like... They're like, oh, we have to like add more ideas or something, I guess. No, that's not gonna work. I have to like time it, I guess.
No, but you can stop each and every single one of them individually.
That's what I'm saying. I think I have to like try to do them in order. Like that one here. No, no, it doesn't. You can't stop them individually. They all. What the hell? Really? Yeah, you can't really do it, because then they...
Try to erase that
too,
one?
That's too tilted.
And then they start filling them up. Okay, now we're getting all like the...
Yeah, no, you can't do it, I'm telling you, because they all use one another for some reason. That's weird, right? Huh.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's kind of annoying that they all use one another, so you can't do it. Maybe we can do this one last, and it'll kind of work, let's see. No, it still doesn't count, because they all have to be still, huh? That is weird, like, what the heck?
Epic Mac. Oh, and then the Ratatouille one, I just remembered.
Oh, wasn't there, like, a PSP one?
And someone said...
It was the best game.
This is the best adaptation.
Adaptation, and it has, like, nothing to do with like, the actual game.
Yeah, we were just like, bro, you are,
like... there's, like, a whole boss fight against that one chef guy. And that's how the game ends, too, right?
Yeah, for no reason. Because everything else has nothing to do with the game.
Yeah, I remember it was, like, super whack, right?
Oh my god, that was funny. The person said that me and you were just like, stop lying.
Yeah, where do we see that? Like, why did we see that?
Oh, it was... I forgot what it was. Because I guess...
Dude, how are we supposed to do it?
It felt like we had mentioned that you said that you saw at like a store, yeah, the Polar Express game for the GameCube. And then this is like really early, like legit, like a morning thing that we were just talking for some reason. And then we were just watching videos of freaking weird...
Dude. Alright, I'm just gonna try it one more time, but I'm gonna move on, cause like...
Yeah.
Yeah, it doesn't count, cause I didn't even start.
Weird-ass adaptation. And then we were talking about that, and we were talking about, like, it was very unnecessary as hell, like, the freaking...
There we go, I got it, there we go. But yeah, like, that, the Ratatouille one, that had nothing to do with, like, it's a game where it's cooking and bonding and, like, all this stuff.
Yeah! Or you would think he would get, like
and for some reason, it was like a platformer slash, I don't even know what you would call it, where all this other stuff was going on. And, like, yeah, he's, like, fighting, like, that one chef guy at the end.
That's it. And that's the only fight.
Yeah, and then, like, that's how the game ends, too, right? Where he, like, fights him, and that's, like, the boss fight, and then, like, the game ends.
And that's how the game ends, supposedly, like, legit. There's never, like, a...
And it's like, what does this have to do at all with,
And apparently, yeah, it was the best adaptation.
So it was, like, I mean, I guess maybe because they thought that, like, I guess they thought that just, like, the movie was too boring, I guess. And so they're like, now this is real action, you know, I guess. I don't know what they meant by that.
Which is weird, because I feel like the movie's not even that boring.
Yeah, like, the movie's fun. So, like, what are you talking about?
But bro, it's so dumb. Like,
I guess someone that, you know, they're like, oh, it's not action-y enough. I want action in my movies, damn it.
Oh my god,
I don't know, it was just funny. Someone's like, this is like the best adaptation ever, and this and that.
Yeah, and then, that reminds me of, like, yeah, like, the GameCube one was a more accurate one. Which is funny, because the GameCube and PS2 one was...
I thought he was gonna die.
The PS2 and GameCube one was the most accurate one, legit.
I know.
That was a crazy... And it was made by the same people who made the Incredibles ones, the GHQ?
Yeah.
Which made this, by the way, so that's the funny
part.
They got way better at making their shit.
Yeah, I guess so, yeah.
Legit. Because we've mentioned that, where you've mentioned about how... That the Incredibles one is both... Oh, and this is where it starts. Yeah, get inside. Oh, this looks way better than the arena.
Hey, look, small Pete. He's like, hey, Mickey. You did it. I might have misjudged you, but watch out, because my cousin over on Main Street makes me seem like a cuddly little kitten. Oh, and help yourself to some treasure. As for me, time to go.
Yeah, so if I remember correctly, yeah, you have to fight some guys now. Ta-ta!
That's... Ooh, yeah. Oh, there we go, you can hear that.
Ooh, a room full of treasure. Okay. Or maybe I'm mistaken. Maybe that's only, like, if he caused problems.
I mean, we did help him. Maybe it's, maybe it's if you don't help him, I guess.
Yeah, I think that's...
That would make sense, right? If you didn't help him, then you would have to fight guys here, but because you helped him, helps you just be like, oh, you know, help yourself to the treasure and, you know, get out of here or whatever.
Mm-hmm.
That's how we came in, right?
Yeah. I was gonna say, I remember when I played it.
Yeah.
I think I've encountered both. I just remembered more of the evil route, where, like, legit, he makes you, like, because it's a Colosseum.
Yeah.
He makes you fight, and that's when you have the option to, like, knock the enemies into the pit, you know?
Yeah.
And that was actually kind of fun because it opens up, and you have to, like, drop them into, like, the thinner.
That's interesting. All right, so hold on.
But yeah, that's what I'm saying. That's so crazy that, yeah, the Ratatouille one was the most accurate one.
Oh my god. It seems like the Polar Express one are really bad.
And then the other one you mentioned, yeah, the Incredibles one was bad because you said that, like, for example, this is why I remember it so well. That's a crazy
part. Like, not everything was bad. Like, that first area where you're playing as a young, Mr. Incredible, right? Because it's supposed to kind of, like, tie into, like, when you're playing the, when you're watching the movie, right?
When he's doing his, like, first, yeah.
Yeah, where they're doing, like, the little, like, interview, right? And then, he's gonna go save the day. That's where he, says no to Buddy and all that stuff, right?
Mm-hmm.
Like, all of that was, like, that part where you're actually playing as Mr. Incredible, it's actually, like, really fun, actually.
Yeah, I can imagine.
But then, like, it has a bunch of random stuff. There's, like, a random running sequence.
That's what I was gonna tell you.
Yeah, about Dash trying to catch the bus.
Yeah.
And then, like, it's really bad, the controls.
Yeah, and then, like, you crash into the bus, and then, like, or crash in general. And then, like, basically what happens is you just have to restart.
Yeah, because, like, you lose all your health. And, like, and it's, like, the controls are, like, really bad.
Yeah.
Or at least I remember them really, really bad.
And you can't stop. You literally can't stop.
Yeah, you can't stop. You just have to navigate and not crash into anything. And it's like, what does this have to do with anything? This isn't even, like, there's not even a scene in the movie about him catching the bus. It's, like, so random.
Yeah, it's weird. And what's funny is, okay, you have to catch the bus, right?
Yeah.
But you don't catch the bus because, you don't catch
the bus. Or, no, maybe it's not him catching the bus. Maybe it's him not running the bus to school, which makes it even dumber.
He missed the bus and he had to get to school, and that's the stupid part. Because,
like, if he doesn't beat the bus to school, why does that matter? Like, it's just so random.
It's such a weird...
Like, the objective makes no sense.
Yeah, and then with the Polar Express, it makes no sense because it's, like, this weird Zelda exploration where you go down, like, the
Yeah,
the top. And then, like, it's, like, you're fighting Scrooge, which I to say that he wasn't in the movie is not true because he is like the guy on the top of the train. It's weird because he's an antagonist for some reason.
Yeah, it's so random. That's the thing about a lot of these license games. They would like add random stuff that has like nothing to do with the actual movie.
And then you fight these weird like Jack in the Boxes for some weird reason.
Yeah.
And that's what I'm saying. Like they're really like Polar Express is one of those movies where there's not really an antagonist. Because even what's his name, Scrooge isn't even like a bad guy. He's just kind of there to tell you that he's kind of a piece of shit, and then like he made a mistake like a long time ago, and that's it.
For all the licensed games, it's like they wanted to capitalize on the movie being out, so it's like, oh, we're gonna make a game to capitalize off it and get people to buy it. But then like it's like they knew that like, a lot of these movies didn't have anything like actually going on that was video gamey, so they had to like make it up as they went along. It was like really funny.
You know what that moon looks like exactly? From Soul Eater.
Oh, it does actually.
It literally, 100%.
It really does. Yeah, that's funny. It really does. All right, so where does this take? Oh, wait, hold on. This is where Pete was, right?
Yeah, this is where you get the stuff.
Oh, interesting. Oh, dude, we have so much tickets.
That's what I'm saying. They're good that we have them because then.
But since we export so much, that's why, guys, if anyone's watching this and being like, "Damn, they like are taking forever," it's because I'm really exploring like everything, right? Just trying to enjoy it, you know? So.
That's why. Oh gosh, just out of nowhere.
I can't jump back up, dang it.
Yes, you can. But yeah, that's what I'm saying. And then, like, that one was weird where you had to fight the Jack in the Boxes and this weird, like, top down thing. And...
Yeah, it was crazy, man. Licensed games, man. Those have kind of not really existed anymore.
That's what I'm saying. That it was like the mid 2000s. That's where they stopped. You can tell, like, literally.
Mm hmm.
Oh, I remember this. This for sure. Based off the name too, what Gus said.
Yeah.
Okay, so let's collect some money.
That's kind of funny. This is the money, technically, for us.
Yeah.
I thought he was gonna land on it.
Gets caught, even though like gets copyrighted for something that's not even like.
We might actually. Because you know how YouTube is, like, oh, this music, it's like, bro, it's like...
Bro, and that's what someone mentioned, actually, that it was hilarious, because, okay, like, the day of January, what was it, January 5th or something like that?
I think it was, right? Because it was right after, like, the year started, yeah, I knew that.
People did was they were making their dubs and a lot of other stuff, right? And one of those dudes, Brad Buxer, or whatever his name, not the one that works with Michael Jackson, by the way, just to make sure. He said that it was so stupid where they copyrighted him for some reason.
Could be because it was still in the system, it hadn't, like, changed it yet.
But even then, after that, a lot of people were talking about, like, legit for a while, that, no, they were, like, trying to, like, purposely, like, be like, no, it's Disney's technique.
They seen what they could get away with, I guess.
Yeah, and then people were like, dude, that doesn't work like that anymore. And someone had done is because, there's that argument that everyone always makes saying that Mickey didn't have colored shorts until the 30s or 40s.
Yeah.
The thing is, we've known that Mickey's design with the red shorts has existed since the very beginning. It's always been there. With the Steamboat Willie, at least.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, you gotta be careful. Oh, we were talking about, oh, and he's dead.
I thought he was gonna, I literally jumped so he wouldn't get hit, and he still got hit. That was lame.
The about to come.
Yeah.
The face again, that's why I just remember.
Oh, yeah.
But yeah, those memes, again, just to kind of like finish off the thing. Yeah, they're so stupid. Oh yeah, that they basically colored the whole cartoon, and it looks really good.
That's cool.
The only reason why it didn't come out so great is this whole thing where, like, since it's old.
And the game crashed. Well,
wow.
That sucks. I mean, we're gonna, like, as soon as we got through this, I was gonna, like, you know,
try to save at least.
I was gonna try to, like, you know, stop the episode anyway, but yeah, the game crashed, so, well, that sucks.
That's stupid, yeah.
Yeah, well, we'll have to see about that next time, guys. But if you like what you saw, I guess, comment, subscribe. Hopefully we're able to fix this. Watch the game just never works again.
Yeah, like, what the...
It just, like, deletes all the data. That would suck.
Yeah, after you get to a certain point, the game just doesn't work.
Right. But, if you guys like what you saw, like I said, like, comment, subscribe, all that good stuff. Thanks a lot, John, for being here.
You're welcome.
And, we'll meet you guys next time where hopefully we're able to fix this little issue, you know? Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.